Hey, good optometry morning. Dr. Michael Nelson, your YouTube eye doctor here, and welcome to Sunday Studies, where I summarize an eye research study. Okay, today I'm summarizing an important study if you are using atropine for myopia progression. It's called the LAMP study. So I'm going to put a link for this study in the description below if you want to read it for yourself, but I'm going to make it super easy for you because I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about the LAMP study. And we're going to do that in less than 6 minutes. So I'm going to give you five pearls to take away, but time is ticking, so let's go. All right, so this study is called the Low-Concentration for Myopia Progression study, and it's sometimes referred to as the LAMP study. There are four phases to this study, and phase one was published in January 2019, and phase two was published in July 2020. So in this video, I'm going to go over phase one and phase two. So there's some important precursor studies to the LAMP study, and they're called the ATOM studies, and I've done a summary to those, and you can get those right up here. Okay, so the ATOM studies showed that low doses of atropine are effective in treating myopia progression, but there were two problems with the ATOM 2 study. Number one, there was not a placebo group in the ATOM 2 study. And number two, the 0.01% concentration didn't seem to have an effect on axial length. So they designed the LAMP studies to try to address the shortcomings of the ATOM studies. And there are three main goals of the LAMP study. Number one, does low-dose atropine prevent progression compared to a placebo? Number two, is there a concentration-dependent response effect of low-dose atropine? And number three, what is the best concentration of low-dose atropine? So LAMP is a randomized placebo-controlled double-masked study with four phases over 5 years. So phase one corresponds to year one, and it looks at placebo, 0.05%, 0.025%, and 0.01% atropine. Phase two corresponds to year two, and the placebo group crosses over to the group that proves to be the most effective in phase one. So phase three, it corresponds to year three, and it's a washout period of 12 months for all participants, except for those that crossed over in year two. And phase four is years four and five. So it's an extended 2 year period where atropine will be continued again in all those that have progressed in phase three. So let's look at the results of phase one. So this looked at about 400 kids aged 4 to 12 years old, and they were either using placebo, 0.05%, 0.025%, or 0.01% atropine, one drop in each eye every evening. So the results of this study, as these graphs show, showed that there was a clear concentration-based response. And so basically what that means is that the higher dose of atropine that they received, the more effective it was in controlling the myopia. This also seemed to apply to axial length. So pearl number one, there is a concentration-dependent effect on myopia control with low-dose atropine. And so there was one interesting thing that they found with the 0.01% concentration. What they found was that there was no significant difference in the axial length of the placebo group compared to this concentration group. So this brings us to pearl number two. 0.01% doesn't seem to have any effect on axial length compared to placebo. All right, so anyone that has used atropine knows that it has side effects. But what they found in this study is that none of these concentrations had really any side effects for any of the participants. So what that means is that the best concentration to be on is the highest concentration in this study. So that brings us to pearl number three. The LAMP study concludes the 0.05% is the most effective in controlling myopia and axial length with minimal symptoms over year one. All right, so let's talk about phase two. Now, phase two looks at year two, and what you might remember from the ATOM 2 study was that the 0.01% concentration had an increased effect in the second year versus the first year. And so that led the researchers of the ATOM 2 study to conclude that the best low concentration of atropine was the 0.01%. Okay, so phase two of the LAMP study did not show this effect. So in the ATOM 2 study, there seemed to be a concentration-dependent effect in year one, but that did not hold for year two. The LAMP study showed that the low doses of atropine remained concentration-dependent over both year one and year two. So that brings us to pearl number four. Concentration-dependent effects remain in the first 2 years. All right, so before I get to the last and the most important pearl, if you've learned anything in this video so far, make sure you hit the like button down below so you can tell YouTube that this is a great video for people to watch. Okay, so here's the summary of phase one and phase two of the LAMP study. All the low dose concentrations of atropine were effective in reducing myopia progression with very little symptoms in all the patients in these studies. But the 0.05% concentration had twice the effect of the 0.01% concentration. So this brings us to pearl number five. The LAMP study phase one and two show that 0.05% is 2 times more effective than 0.01% over 2 years. Okay, so the results of the ATOM 2 study resulted in an increase in optometrists using 0.01% to treat myopia. But the results of the lab study indicate that eye doctors should be using 0.05% concentration for myopia management. All right, so if you're like me, you're looking forward to the results of phase 3 and phase 4 of this study. So make sure you hit the subscribe and the notification bell so you can be alerted when I put a video out on those. And with that, have a great optometry day.